Hey guys, Dr. Michael Van here, and today I want to talk about the importance of deep sleep. The importance of sleep. And let's be honest, we've all heard of that general recommendation that we should all get between 7 and 9 hours of sleep to kind of function optimally throughout the day. You know, as long as you have your 8 hours of sleep, you're good to go. But the truth is, the quantity of your sleep is not all that matters. In fact, what is just as important is your quality of sleep. And I happen to have an Oura ring, and the thing is with the Oura ring is I can track my sleep quality and all the different stages of sleep. And sometimes when I wake up in the morning and I'm looking at my levels of deep restorative sleep that I get, sometimes my readings are almost laughable, like literally 0 to 10 minutes of deep restorative sleep. And so many people think, oh, I get 8 hours of sleep, I'm good to go. But really, if you're finding out that you're not getting proper deep amount of sleep, then your body is really gonna, you know, it's gonna take a toll on its body, and it's really gonna have a lot of detrimental effects on your lifestyle, on the function, and how you're able to kind of just get by throughout the day. And that's what we're gonna be going over today. Now, before we go into the physiology of deep sleep and how important it is, I first want to do a little review of the different sleep stages that we do. And generally, depending on your reference, you're going to have 4 to 5 stages of sleep. And really what this comes down to is it comes down to REM sleep and non-REM sleep. Of course, REM stands for rapid eye movement. So that's like your dreamy sleep when you're actually dreaming in the night. But stages 1 through 4 are your non-REM sleep, and stages 5 is classified as your REM state of sleep. Again, some references are a little bit different, but that's the general idea. And stages 3 and 4, those are gonna be the stages where you're getting that deep restorative sleep, what we're gonna be talking about this afternoon. And all stages of sleep are important. You know, you wanna have your light sleep, you wanna have your deep sleep, you definitely wanna have your REM sleep as well, but deep sleep seems to be of paramount importance, and right now we're gonna go over the functions of what deep sleep actually has. During deep sleep, which is also known as slow wave sleep or delta sleep, because on your EEG readings, it consists of slow delta waves, what you're gonna find in a characteristic of deep sleep is you're gonna find your heart rate, your blood pressure, your breathing rate, and your body temperature to be at its very lowest point. So when you're in deep sleep, all these parameters are at its very lowest. So you're gonna find that your respiratory rate, your blood pressure, everything is super, super suppressed during this restorative state of sleep. And your brain waves as well are also at their very lowest point in deep sleep. And this is also classified as when you're in that deep sleep, it's very difficult for your body to awaken. So if people walk into the bedroom, opening and shutting the door, you're hearing sirens outside, you're not gonna be able to awaken. Most people won't, unless you're a light sleeper, but most people will not awaken during this deep stage of sleep that they're in. Now, why is deep sleep so important? Well, it's important for a number of reasons, but the first reason is that this is when your pituitary gland in your brain is releasing all of these important hormones, especially human growth hormone. So when your body's in that deep sleep, that's when your body's releasing growth hormone. And we all know that growth hormone, which is also known as your fitness hormone, it's responsible for healing, growth, and repair. And so basically it's ensuring that your body is regenerating and developing and recovering properly throughout the night. So if you're not getting deep sleep, you're not getting that nice human growth hormone release, and you're not getting healing, growth, and repair, and your body's not able to recover properly and regenerate. The second property of deep sleep is that this is when your body is repairing, when it's cleansing, and when your brain is detoxifying. And just like the rest of your body, you have this lymphatic system that's responsible for basically removing waste and toxins out of your body. Well, your brain has the same thing, but it doesn't really have a lymphatic system. They call it the glymphatic system. And only when you're in that deep state of sleep is when that glymphatic system functioning is at its very peak. And so again, just like the rest of your body, your brain accumulates waste, and those wastes need to be removed by your glymphatic system. And so if your glymphatic system is not working properly, from not getting enough deep sleep when the lymphatic system is supposed to be at its optimum, what you're gonna see is you're gonna find a toxic buildup of toxins, of waste, of debris that a lot of times lead to neurological dysfunction, brain fog, as well as increasing your chance of developing neurodegenerative diseases, such as dementia or Alzheimer's. And Alzheimer's, for one thing, it's classified as a buildup of toxic waste products known as beta amyloid proteins and tau proteins. And what happens is that when you're in deep sleep, what's awesome and what I find so fascinating is that your brain cells will actually shrink. And they're actually gonna shrink up to a portion of about 60%. And the reason why you see these brain cells shrink is because then it opens up these passageways in between the brain cells where your lymphatic system can start to flush cerebral spinal fluid through those little nooks and crannies between your brain cells to flush out all of those toxins, all of those waste products, and all of those debris. And so if you're not getting deep sleep, that lymphatic system is going to be suppressed, not causing this flushing out of toxic removal, and it could possibly lead to things like neurodegenerative disorders, like dementia, Alzheimer's, as well as brain fog, and just your brain not functioning at its optimum, which is what we all want. The third awesome property of sleep is that it also seems to reduce DNA damage and increases the repairing mechanisms of your DNA. And what deep sleep actually does is when you're in that deep state of sleep, your brain and your DNA are actually getting repaired, and specifically the cells in your brain, because what happens during the day, we get a toxic buildup of DNA damage, no different than we get a toxic buildup of waste that need to be removed from our lymphatic system. But we also get a toxic kind of accumulation of DNA broken strands. And so at nighttime, when we're in that deep state of sleep, we need to repair that. And that's exactly what that does. When you're in deep sleep, your body seems to ramp up its ability to repair all of those breaks in its DNA damage and those chromosomes, and it repairs that. So you're able to repair all of those cells that are accumulating lots of damage. And so to summarize that point, when you're in deep sleep, that's when your body's repairing all of its damage to its chromosomes and its DNA to really help your cells thrive at its best. And so the bottom line is that if you're not getting enough adequate sleep, we're not increasing growth hormone like we should be, we're not getting that healing, growth, repair, recovery, and regeneration that our body needs, we're also not getting our lymphatic system to remove toxic waste and debris from our brain cells, leading to an accumulation of beta amyloid, of tau proteins, and other waste products that are not good and that can cause mental fogginess, brain dysfunction, as well as neurodegenerative disorders like Alzheimer's and dementia. And then finally, if you're not getting deep sleep, you're also not getting that repair mechanisms of your DNA and of your chromosomes. And so that's why deep sleep is so important. And that's why for me, when I look at my Oura ring and I see those really horrible numbers of deep sleep, that really is a wake-up call, because I now know that I'm not releasing growth hormone to repair my body, I'm not repairing my DNA damage, and I'm not removing toxic waste products. And so if I want to function at my optimum, I need to optimize, we need to optimize our deep sleep. And one thing that we're going to be talking about in this series is the specific steps we can take to optimize our deep sleep, whether that's through our own body, whether it's our lifestyle, or it's our bedroom, how to optimize that. We're going to talk about different factors, different hacks, if you will, that will help you optimize deep sleep naturally so you can be functioning at your best each and every day. Thanks for listening. This is Dr. Michael Van, and stay tuned for the next video where we're going to talk about strategies that you can implement to optimize our deep sleep.